We back. Good day, my beautiful people. I hope everything is good and all is well with all of you. And we are back with another video. Because it's been quite a while. My apologies. But today, I'm super excited to check out the track that we're listening to right now. So Map of the Soul, The Journey from BTS, track Stay Gold, pre-release from the entire album. I'm super, super excited, you know, for the entire album to drop. You know, another Japanese album. I love it. I enjoy, you know, BTS's Japanese releases. Speaking of like BTS's Japanese releases, let me know what are your favorite ones. I was actually thinking about it, you know, and kind of revisiting some of the tracks from, you know, those Japanese releases that they have had over the years. And I feel like we all know Crystal Snow is a classic. It's a classic. It always has been a classic. It will be a classic for you, right? But probably one of my all-time favorites out of the Japanese releases probably has to be Don't Leave Me. And it's just beautiful. I love that song because of the arrangement for it, you know, and all the synthesizers and everything. And the vocal-wise, I feel like Jimin shines on that track very much so. And it's like, whoa. Like everybody does. But, you know, anyhow. I could ramble about that song and any other track, you know, BTS related for a very, very long time. But today, Map of the Soul, The Journey, track Stay Gold, an original soundtrack for an upcoming Japanese drama, which is interesting, which is really, really cool. We all love soundtracks. I do enjoy a good soundtrack. Right, we have listened to soundtracks here, but we're gonna take a listen to the song. The music video for it is also dropping soon, so when that, you know, comes out, we will watch the video for it and revisit the song, of course. But let's get it, let's listen to it, let's pick out some details as much as possible, let's appreciate the creativity, the art, the everything. And I've read the lyrics, by the way, beforehand. I've read the lyrics already for it. The lyrics were beautiful. I loved it. But as y'all know, me as a bass player, we are always searching for a great bass line, a great, you know, kind of a detail, a great drum pattern, drum groove, sample, everything. So we're gonna get it. So let's get it. Stay Gold. Let's have a listen. I'm not ready. Ooh.
In a world where you feel cold, you gotta stay gold, oh baby.
Wow. Okay. Ooh, I love that synthesizer in the back.
Ooh.
I love this one. Yo, wait. Ooh, okay, I love how they're playing with the rhythm. Hey. Ooh, acoustic guitars, pianos, some analog sounds, synthesizer-wise. Beautiful. A lot of reverb, a lot of hall. Oh, I love it. Ooh, this kind of anthem moment. Ooh, ooh, the bass. Hey. Ooh. I love this kind of a little stompy kind of groove to it. I feel like the emphasis is on three, you know, so kind of gives you that rolling motion within the beat. Ooh, the bass is killer on this. I love the tone of the bass as well. Very, very warm tone bass.
Okay.
So good. Oh,
no,
four-part harmony in the background, vocals as a choir. Wow, this is very groovy. It's very simple, like, there's not a lot happening, like, instrument-wise, but it's great. I love the backup vocals a lot. The bass is genius on this. Beautiful. I love everyone's tone on this very much so. Ooh. Okay, them high notes. Ooh, okay. Okay, hi, semitones. Beautiful. Beautiful. Ooh. I love the air. There's a lot of air coming through those vocals. I love it. Yo, this is so beautiful. Wait. I wasn't expecting these. It sounds wonderful. It sounds beautiful. I love this, you know, this is a brilliant soundtrack if we kind of look at it from a soundtrack point of view. It's a brilliant soundtrack. A very, very good. I don't know if it's going to be like an opening soundtrack or ending credits kind of a soundtrack or, you know, a soundtrack, you know, like a theme throughout, you know, the series and whatnot, but it's brilliant. It's brilliant. It's super, super minimalistic. I love those acoustic instruments, right? I love those analog synthesizers within it. I love the bass line. The bass line is just beautiful on this. Let me know if I should record a bass video for this, because the bass is, yes, the bass is yes, because I love the bass line on this. I love the tone of the bass. I love the analog synthesizers on this. It gives you a very, very old school, kind of lo-fi, not a lot of lo-fi, but just a little lo-fi kind of a feel to it, right? It's super, super warm tone. Like, everything is super, super warm tone. Like, all the guitars are very, very warm tone. Pianos, even, like, the acoustic piano that we got there, right? The analog synthesizers we got there. Even the bass is super, super muddy, super warm, right? Even, like, the drums and everything, and, right? And that kind of rolling motion, kind of a groove, right? With the emphasis on three. So, It's just great, right? It's a little stompy. It's great that it's stompy. It gives you, you know, kind of, you know, a little laid back kind of a feel, right? It's genius. It's great. I love it. I love the, yo, vocals, rap vocals. Yo, wait. It's brilliant. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. Starting off, you know, from everyone rapping and singing, and especially Hobi, yo, singing and rapping, and Junkee singing and rapping. Actually, everyone was, like everyone from the rap line was kind of a little singy. I love how Jun was playing with the rhythm, playing a lot of with syncopation, you know, through you know, his verse and everything. It's really, it just gave a very sneaky kind of a feel, if that makes any sense, right? And him, you know, playing, you know, with this melody rhythm, right, throughout his verse, it's genius. It's brilliant. I loved everyone's vocals on this. I loved everyone's tone on this. Tay shines on this very, very much so. I love his tone. I love his voice very, very much so. Jimin, Jan, JK, right? Everyone. It's beautiful, right? Especially like JK's like runs and kind of like these ad vocals at the end. Genius! I loved it! Very much so. Like, He's the king improviser. Like, he knows how to improvise. He knows, you know, what might sound good, right? He has this kind of a feel and kind of this. I wouldn't say, you know, sometimes, a lot of times whenever, you know, people improvise singing, you know, improvise, you know, composing and everything, and or just, you know, improvise music in general. A lot of times, the more you do it, you know, the crazier you can get, you know, with all of those riffs and runs and melodies and tones and sounds and, you know, and kind of expression, whatever you want to tell within, you know, within the song. But, you know, him also playing, you know, with the rhythm, like all of them were super, super, you know, they're very, very melodic, very singing and everything. But then again, when they start playing with the rhythm of the backing track or the drums specifically or the pianos, you know, and they just start, you know, playing around with it, you know, within their vocal melodies and everything. Oh, such a beautiful color, such a beautiful color. And it's great. Like, this is great. You know, I like this a lot. I like this very much so. They went super minimalistic. I live for minimalism within music. I love minimalism within music. This was, you know, of course, as it is, you know, made for the Japanese market, you know, the Japanese music market, you know, and just kind of the music scene in general. It's a little bit different, right? Their kind of musical expectations, what is running, you know, what is becoming more and more popular, within the music industry within Japan, right? It's way different than it is, you know, in Korea. It's way different than it is, you know, in States, Europe, you know, and everything and so on. So, and I feel like this track very much so captures very well, you know, what the music industry, you know, in Japan might enjoy very much. So it's very light, right? It's very, very light. It's very, very pleasing to the ears. It's something that you can listen to, you know, in the background if you wish to. Like, if you wish to. Like, the lyrics are beautiful for this song, right? And it just kind of hits you when you listen to this, right? And especially if you listen to this over and over again, I feel like it's gonna hit you every single time. And it's definitely something that you will remember, especially, right? It's chosen for a soundtrack. Soundtracks are supposed to be something memorable and something that you can, you know, like, that was there, right? This song was, you know, in this drama, in this movie, this TV series, and everything. So, this is very well made. This is very, very, very well made, and I enjoyed it every single bit of it. I love the vocals on this very much, so I love the instrumental arrangement for this. I love the bass line on this, so let me know if I should record a bass video for it. And I will leave you to that. If there are any... actually, do let me know your favorite Japanese releases from BTS, and if there are, you know, any specific ones that you would like for me to listen to and react to, do definitely let me know in the comments down below. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you're having a wonderful weekend. Stay safe, stay healthy, eat well, and as I usually say, always remember to be good, be kind, rock and roll, and I will see y'all very, very soon with a new video. Cheers! I'm